Hi everyone, I'm Astha. Today I will talk a bit about the Amazon software engineer interview process. After watching this video, you should have a good overview of the process, what the interviewers filter for, and a couple of tips on preparing for this. Quick intro. I'm from Prepfully. On Prepfully, you can practice for free with other candidates, get specific targeted advice from interview coaches who've been software engineers in your target companies, or contact your resumes reviewed anonymously by recruiters who actively hire for software engineer roles in the companies that you're applying at. So, in that context, this overview has been put together with the help of Amazon software engineers, the very same ones who have helped hundreds of candidates with mock interviews and advice. As always, if you have questions on a specific aspect of the Amazon software engineer interview process that I don't cover here, ask in the comments below. And if you find this short video helpful, please like it and subscribe. Right then, enough talk and on to the overview. In a nutshell, there are four steps to the Amazon software engineer interview process. The first step will be resume screening. The second step will be the HR recruiter call. The third step is the Amazon online assessments. And the fourth step is the technical phone screens. Lastly, there will be an on-site interview at the end. Let's talk about step one first. The first step for the Amazon is the resume screening. First, recruiters will review your resume and assess if your experience matches the open position. This is the most competitive step in the process, as millions of candidates do not make it past this stage. You should focus on making sure that your resume is well suited to the job for which you are applying. One easy and effective strategy is to focus on the skills listed by the hiring manager or the recruiter in the job description. If you think advice from an Amazon recruiter could help on this front, there are several available on Prepfully who can help with resume reviews. Now, the second step is the recruiter email or call. So the interview process starts with an HR recruiter call to discuss your interests and determine which group or team would be best suited for you. Your recruiter will also use this conversation to confirm that you've got a chance of getting the job. You should be prepared to explain your background and why you're a good fit for Amazon. The best way to prepare for the Amazon SWE interview is to practice with an Amazon SWE mentor. To do this, you may either ask friends or connections on LinkedIn for help or use a professional platform like Prepfully to connect with one of the Amazon SWEs who have mentored hundreds of candidates. If things go well, the recruiter will send you an online assessment or schedule your technical screen depending on your applying role. Now, the third step is the Amazon online assessments. Amazon primarily uses online assessments or OAs for internship and new graduate positions and sometimes for experienced jobs as well. Therefore, you might have to solve up to 3 online assessments before progressing to the technical phone screen stage. The online assessment is a set of 2 data structures and algorithm questions. Each question needs to be solved within a certain amount of time, example 30 minutes, and your code must compile for the 2 questions to move forward in the interview process. Before submitting a solution, you can compile your code as often as you want. You can use the following 8 languages: C#, C++, Java, C Python, Python, Ruby, Swift, and JavaScript. Efficiency and optimization earn more points than brute force solutions. We'd strongly recommend practicing a lot for online assessments. You can try out our mock interview feature, which can get you targeted feedback on whether you're ready for an Amazon-level interview from the Amazon engineers themselves. An important note, this online assessment is used for internships, new graduates, and sometimes experienced positions. The more senior that you are, the more complex questions you will get. Now, the fourth step, that is the technical phone screen. You'll be invited to 1 or 2 technical phone screens if you have passed the online assessments or weren't asked to take them. This step is called the phone screen, but most of the time it takes place over video chat using Amazon Chime, the company's own video conferencing product. Each interview will last about 45 to 60 minutes. You'll speak to a peer or a potential manager, and they'll ask you a mix of technical and behavioral questions. For the technical part of the interview, you can expect typical data structure and algorithm questions. You'll have to solve them in an online collaborative text editor such as CollabEdit. Unfortunately, the editor won't have syntax highlighting or autocomplete features, which you'll need to get used to during your interview prep. Your recruiter will share a list of software development topics that Amazon asks about in interviews. As a note, it's doubtful that you'll be asked system design questions during your phone screen. For the behavioral part, you can expect questions like, "Tell me about yourself," "Why Amazon?" or "Tell me about a feature that you developed from start to finish." When answering the most common interview questions, express your understanding of Amazon's leadership principles. Finally, there is the on-site round. If you crack the phone screen, the next step is to spend an entire day at one of Amazon's offices and to participate in 4 to 6 interviews. These interviews will last about an hour and be one-on-one with a mix of people from the team that you're applying to join, including peers, the hiring manager, and a senior executive. 3 or 4 of your interviews will include coding questions, that is data structure and algorithm questions, which you'll need to solve on a whiteboard. The other 1 or 2 interviews will cover system design questions. You'll be asked behavioral questions in all your interviews. All candidates are expected to do exceptionally well in coding and behavioral questions. If you're relatively junior, SDE2 or below, the bar will be lower in your system design interviews than for mid-level or senior engineers, example SDE3 or above. One common mistake candidates make is to under-prepare for behavioral questions. Each interviewer is usually assigned 2 to 3 leadership principles to focus on during the interview. Can you work with a cross-functional team? Can you demonstrate leadership with influence rather than authority? Can you handle conflict and influence senior stakeholders? These questions are much more critical at Amazon than at other big tech companies like Google or Facebook. Finally, one of your last interviews will be what Amazon calls a bar raiser. These interviewers are not associated with the team that you'll be applying for and focus more on the candidate quality than the specific team needs. They get unique training to ensure Amazon's hiring standards stay high and do not degrade over time, so they're a significant barrier between you and the job offer. Right, that's all for this guide in a nutshell. 4 steps to cracking the Amazon Engineering Manager interview are: your resume will decide whether you get selected or not. The initial interviews will be based on the fundamentals, and the on-site will dig deep into all the skills you'll need to succeed at Amazon. Good. That's all from us. Once you feel ready for some practice or just want a sense check of your preparation level, you can book an anonymous mock interview with a software engineer from Prepfully. There's a link in the description below. In addition, you can check out our in-depth written guide, which will get updated constantly as to any changes made in the hiring process. Finally, if you have follow-up questions about the interview, ask in the comments below. And if you find this video helpful, do not forget to like and subscribe. Thanks and good luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.